I'm an infectious disease specialist in Northern California, and I'm the Chief Medical Information Officer for NorthBay Healthcare, an integrated delivery network of community hospital and primary care clinics in Northern California, about halfway between San Francisco and Sacramento. We had made a heavy investment in our electronic health record system beginning in 2003, had already implemented computerized provider order entry, CPOE, in 2009 before the stage one meaningful use standards were available. We were already making a substantial investment in using electronic health record to improve the quality of care of our patients and to improve the efficiency of our enterprise. So it was natural to just go the extra effort to get recognized financially by the federal government. It was surprisingly, there was some more work to be done than where we had done. For us, CPOE was already finished. That was pretty easy. We met that before we even started. But there were a number of requirements that required careful consideration and collaboration among many stakeholders, not just physicians, but nurses, administrative personnel, revenue cycle management, HIM professionals. For instance, the requirement to give a discharge summary to the patient in electronic form, or release of records to the patient in electronic form, a care summary when they departed the hospital in electronic form. Those were things we had never contemplated before. We had to come up with some new strategies about how to deliver that to the patients. We've only achieved meaningful use and attested in the inpatient setting. We have an outpatient deployment of our electronic health record with our primary care clinics. We are planning to attest in that domain as well, but we have some work ahead of us, some challenges on the quality metrics and some challenges around getting e-prescribing up and running. I think one of the key things that any organization has to do is, before they even go down this path, is have appropriate governance in place. And it doesn't matter if you're the smallest physician office or if you're a hospital. You need to have the right people sitting at the table who are decision makers, and they have to be both clinicians and administrative and IT, who can sit and make decisions about the finite pool of resources that your organization has and how they're going to be dedicated to achieving this goal and to be able to make decisions. We had to make trade-offs as we decided to pursue meaningful use. We thought it was worthwhile as an organization to do these things, but it meant other projects that were also important to us had to be put aside or put on the back burner. And it was best for those decisions to be made collaboratively by all the stakeholders at an appropriate level of shared governance. Once you have that shared governance, then those providers the shared governance can then begin to make a decision around how to best use the internal resources of the organization. That includes both money and human resources, and how they can be devoted to doing the work that they need to do. So my best advice to a small practice that's just getting started would be to start with the vision of where you want your practice to be and why you're doing it. I think the best advice I heard about meaningful use was from one of my colleagues who said, you don't go have children just to get the tax write-off. And in the same way, you shouldn't just put in an EHR just to benefit financially from it. The net trade-off is not going to be in favor of the pure money. Implementing an EHR is really the beginning. It's the beginning of the transformation of how you deliver care in your practice. And it's the starting gun, because once you have that fabulous tool in place, there are many, many things you can do to drive better care and to make your life more efficient. But if you've just put in that EHR and then you say, I'm done, on to the next project, then you'll forever be mired in those initial inefficiencies and those initial decisions you made before you understood the consequences of implementing the EHR. You have to It's the same thing we do in all parts of medicine we should be doing, is plan, do, study, act. Keep doing iterative refinements and cycles of improvement using the EHR, and eventually you'll get to a much better place. think patients eventually are going to have to get more engaged in their healthcare. Today, we see a growing movement of participatory medicine and more patients getting involved. It hasn't spread widely yet, although in the Bay Area, we have a lot of very savvy healthcare consumers. Eventually, it's nice that one channel of the meaningful use requirements is specifically around patient engagement and allowing them to get electronic copies of their health record and encouraging organizations like ours to think about patient portals and ways for patients to communicate with their physicians. I know that's not specific to meaningful use, but that's the direction meaningful use is headed. I think we've had a change in the conversation in the last few years from, is it worth it for me to implement electronic health records, to how can I now use these tools? And this is the direction that the whole country is going. We're no longer talking about the brave early adopters. We're not talking about the masses actually talking about implementing the electronic health records. And that's great, because then we can elevate the conversation, because implementing electronic health records is the starting line. It's the beginning.